Well, I'm not too superstitious, but I knock on wood a lot. I'm a touchy feely fool, to give anything, to not give a shit, but someday won't this be funny? Well, I want it funny now.
Listening to it, I didn't like it that much. I could vibe to it because it's like you're going off the adrenaline of the album. It's like this, the second song. You can dance to it. That's why I need a second listen, is because I want to really take in the lyrics. And I think the lyrics of Touchy Feely Fool is just like, I wish I could be hard. I'm sensitive though. I feel things. And that's kind of lame, low key. I'm just a touchy feely fool. And I thought I liked the message a lot more than I like the overall song. I don't know musical terms, so I can't describe anything accurately. But yeah, I like it, but it's not going to be on my, like, repeats.
Okay.
I leave my house at 3 o'clock with 200 texts and 2 missed calls. And I took a job for just July, but feels like I might be here for life. Yeah, I'm in it now. I'm in it now. Yes, I'm a mess with an S on my chest. Got stress filling up my hands. I like myself like this. Cheers to the front end, cheers to the back end, cheers to the 2010.
Yes, I'm a mess. Yes, I'm a mess is highly addictive. That's the thing about a lot of AJR songs, is like the first album listen is always will be the craziest experience of any musical people that I listen to, because lyrically, like, they just really tap into their most personal journalistic thoughts, and yet it goes hard every time. Like, that's what I really love about them. Yes, I'm a mess. It's just like a banger. It will be on my repeats. It has been on my repeats. Yeah. Let me not start washing my face as I need to listen to the dumb song.
Kings. Kings. The dumb song.
You said with certainty, I may be the dumbest person that you've ever seen. Probably mess it up. Your world is ending soon. Mine's a little better cause I never watch the news.
You should not have done that.
Don't look at me, don't look at me. I'm just too dumb.
No, I do like that song. It's a banger. Are you kidding?
The dumb song, great. Love the idea of them just kind of putting their most innermost kind of insecure thoughts out into a song and making it absolutely slap. I've already listened to this song like 1,000 times. It reminds me of Week, kind of, to like emphasize on the idea of like, hey, I have this like super, super duper flaw, but it's like, ah, let's vibe out to it. Let's vibe out. Yeah, I has been on repeat, will be on repeat.
Better, but you do what you can.
Do what you can.
Understand,
understand.
I was gonna save the planet, but today I got plans.
Guess this is just what I am.
Where I am going is right where I
god, sick. That was so good. Oh my god.
No, for sure. For sure, like number two of the album.
Woo! Inertia! Shout out to learning that in like the fifth grade. Inertia. Such a good concept of the idea of like, listen, we're all like supposed to move forward, but some of us are literally right where we are, and that's like our path, like, is to low-key be stagnant, but still kind of moving forward, because it's like inertia, like, so interesting. I love that song. It's my probably number two of the album. It's great. Initially, I had the same reaction as I do now, and I've listened to it probably like four times since last night when I first listened to it. Four times is even like a low ball. Anyways, yeah, inertia was great.
Got it out of my system, didn't I? Did my 2 years on Tinder, didn't I? Well, I wanted to be wanted. Suddenly I'm wanting more. It's the best thing that's happened to me. Half the time I can't love right, and I can't have sex and we both get quiet. It'll be fine, quick, let's get married. Though I'm riddled with doubts, is this how we turn out? Hey, I love how you laugh when we're alone, but you're late and you're messy, aren't you? And time I can't love right, and I'm half yours and you're all mine. One day at a time, kid, I think you'll turn out to like it.
I've never really been a big fan of all of the turning outs, part one, part two, but part three I think is the one that's gonna get me, because it just, the thing is, I love the sentiment of the turning outs, because at least in this song it's very apparent that every single album has a turning out, because it's like we're constantly like seeing how we're gonna turn out, so let's just put the one song on the album to represent like the turning out of each album in our stage of life. And that one, I think the storytelling was the most phenomenal and the most, I don't know, like well produced. I don't know anything about music. Also, I am gonna be like trying to pull together music jargon, and it's like, girl, you struggle to know what notes are. The turning outs are such Ryan's heart. I don't even know if it, like, he's the one who writes them and then like records them. I don't, just because he's the voice. God, that was so beautiful. Wow. Hole in the bottom of my brain. There are so many in mine for sure. Like,
okay, whoa, that's the thing I love about AJR. Is very it's not philosophical, but kind of like modern silly philosophical.
Sheesh,
quirky. I actually really like that song. It's just kind of like a that's like a I don't know, I feel like as somebody with anxiety, there's probably like multiple little holes in my brain that think that multiple little meaningless voids can fill it. But I just love that that's personified in this song. Super fun, super like, it's just fun. Like, it's a goofy little song. I can imagine like not a lot of people would be like down for it. It's like one of the quirkier songs that they have, but it's so fun. It's good. It's good. The DJ is crying for help. One of the singles that came out early, of course, that I've already listened to on repeat. Already listened to one for me. Actually, I'm gonna skip the JJ's crying for help.
reacts, and it's like a part of the album, but it's not like an album reaction because I've already heard it, so the illusion doesn't have to be like.
Put your hands up, cause I won't. Hello, how you doing? Am I talking too fast? Cause I do what you tell me to and do it to death. Raise a glass up, cause I won't. I must have missed the hype, but maybe that's the way I feel. I don't got a body like I see in the press. So I got to the precipice of pressing my chest. You come to life, you're bored to death. But maybe that's the way I feel.
That song has been released. It's been released. I just forgot it because I don't really listen to it. So, I won't, as an introvert, really speaks to me. Really speaks to me. It's just the idea of like, listen, no. And that's the review. It's just the idea of no. And I appreciate the idea of no. It's so funny, but it's so fun too. Yeah, like, so far, I think my least favorite on the album is just Turning Out Part 3. That's literally it. But I want was get it bangs. Steve's going to London. Them and their quirks, bro.
Steve's going to London. Sean's stuck in a suit. Okay. Dan peed in the pool.
Well.
Hey, hey, look around, look around. Wouldn't it be nice? There's a song that's on. Write a cool song, so I start with something simple like trying to put my shoes on. I try throwing something cool on, so I'm listening to Kendrick and playing the swimming pool song. Who really needs a cool song? There's so many better melodies, why do you need a new one? You're losing their attention, buddy, move on. See, he's going to London.
What the hell you gotta do?
The quirk, it's just the quirk of AJR. It's just like, but it's so lovable, it's so cute. Like,
oh my God. I can't get out of bed. There's something in his lungs, I think that's what the doctor said. The earth is spinning like it always did. The New York Times. And each day when the world wakes up, our lawns will still be wet. God is really real when you really, really need him. Hear it loud and clear, just as long as it's convenient. And God's f***ing fake till he's not. God is really real when you really, really need him. F***ing long till it stops. And God's f***ing fake till he's not. I'll sing for you when you're out of bed.
That one is absolutely the most emotional thing I've ever heard. Like, not the most emotional thing I've ever heard, but that really just hurts so bad because they're H.I.R.'s brothers. Everybody knows that if they're on this video, but, and their dad died really recently. I don't even know these people, but I really will shed a tear because it's absolutely horrible. And their dad is like a key feature in their music. I think some of his voice is in like some of their songs and things. intimate. It's just so intimate. And it's a like it's a good song because it's so philosophical, because it is that kind of idea of you believe in God when you feel like you need him, and then when you don't, he doesn't exist to you. But like when you really need him, you need him. Personally, I was like kind of anxious to listen to this and do the reaction because like I'd already listened to a little bit of it before, and like as a Christian, I was like, I don't know if I want to listen to this. Like, it makes me a little uncomfortable, but I'm like, that's just the realism of what that song means. Like 2085. Actually, I'm gonna listen to this tomorrow when I do my second reactions, but this is gonna be obviously initial reaction later. 2085.
If somebody told me I'd die at 40, I wouldn't have spent my time in bed. I should have just grown up instead. Sometimes I wonder if I had kissed her, how different life would be right now.
I'd hate to have to die before I get my head put together.
'Cause I spent my whole life trying to be so light, that only made them hate me more. Did I wish I was me, whoever that is. I'll be whatever makes you a fan, 'cause I don't know who the hell I am. If I could be me, I would have been it by now. It looks like our time is running out. Take all the shit so you never have, so you can be you, and I'll be the rest. And I do.
I don't even know what to do with that. I really don't even know what to do with that. Woo! I don't know I know why I'm emotional, because that was a very emotional album. It's like full of, you know, songs that you can dance in your living room to and like be alone with, but Turning Out, God's Really Real, and the fact that this whole album is based in simply just like self-exploration and like the maybe of life, the maybe man, like that was incredibly touching. I love them. I can't wait to see them on tour. Hopefully I'll see whoever the heck is watching this on tour. This was very moving. Also, the idea to just make an album, I think they started it when their dad was sick and then he passed away, like I think towards the end, or maybe they finished, I don't know, but wow. It really does show that like something happened to them. Whew, and that's just real art. Phenomenal album, wow. The only one that I would skip, really, the Turning Outs for me, like, are incredibly touching, but the ones that I tend to repeat are the ones that like absolutely go really hard, which is like the ones that are a lot less like, they're just as meaningful, packed with substance, but just more like songs you can dance to. Not to say that it's bad. None of these songs are bad, in my opinion. Well, Touchy Feely Full, I don't know if I'll dance to like a ton, but I do appreciate it. I can't review music at all. I'm not a musical person. Sorry about that. But as a regular person reviewing an album that I really like, fabulous. Great. They did it again, boys. They did it again. It's crazy. Their dad would be so proud of this. I don't even know. That's real, but for sure. Like, woo! I'm gonna cry about this. And I'll see you later.